family and friends. We have gathered here today to joyfully acknowledge the wedding of Cody Ewing and Taylor Steffel. They have requested your presence at this memorable occasion in order that you might share with them the pledging of their everlasting love in this day of commitment. We wish for them all the happiness in their new life together. The Bible has much to say on the subject of marriage. From the very beginning, God established and endorsed the covenant of marriage. Immediately after creating man, the Lord realized his masterpiece was incomplete. Something was missing. God had fashioned this fabulous garden with the plants and trees and animals and put Adam in charge of all of it. Still though, God said, "It is not good enough for the man to be alone. I'll make him a companion, a helper." So God put Adam into a deep sleep and created Eve out of Adam. When Adam awoke and saw Eve, he said finally,
"Me?"
to let the bees fly. Finally, bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. That's where scripture says, "Therefore, a man leaves his father and mother and embraces his wife. They become one flesh. The two of them, the man and the wife, were naked, but they felt no shame." The marriage is about two people who search, is satisfied, each has found and fallen in love with the one with whom they can be totally vulnerable and feel no shame. That is love. Not love as Hollywood presents it, but love as God designed it. In his letter to the Corinthians, Paul says this about love. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than self. Love doesn't want, it doesn't have. Love doesn't strut. Doesn't have a swelled head, doesn't force itself on others. It's always me first, isn't always me first. Doesn't fly off the handle, doesn't keep score of the sins of others. Doesn't revel when others grovel. Takes pleasure in the flowering of truth, puts up with anything, trusts God always. Always looks for the best, never looks back, but keeps going to the end. Love never dies. It is that special, elusive treasure that has brought us all together. Love. Cody and Taylor love each other. They invited us because they love us. We are here because we love them. Before we leave that subject, though, I'd like to give the friends and family here today a special charge. In the best of circumstances, marriage is a dicey proposition. Today in these beautiful surroundings, caught up in the essence of this heady moment, it will be easy for Cody and Taylor to vow their undying love to each other. In the days to come though, they will face difficulties, all relationships do, and I would ask those that care about Cody and Taylor to pray for them. Even beyond that, if one of them should come to you and complain about their marriage, please love them enough to remind them of the vows they are about to take. Listen to them, care for them, commiserate with them, but send them home to get it worked out.
I think they can sit down.
You see, the gatherings is not so much about a wedding. A wedding is just one day, the first step of a journey that lasts a lifetime. This gathering is about a marriage, a covenant, two becoming one. Who gives this woman away?
I do.
Now you can go.
Please.
Yes, you make the laugh.
Thank you.
Please be seated.
Okay, good.
Oh. Cody and I worked that out already.
Okay, good.
Oh. Yeah, we figured it out.
Okay.
Executive decisions.
Yes.
Please bow your heads for a prayer. Lord, you've brought these two together for a new life, to start their own family, to begin what their parents have done before them and grandparents. Every day will be a journey, a new quirk to figure out between them. We thank you that you have brought them together. Nobody ever knows the day that it would happen, why it would happen, but it happened. And the next day will be the same. We thank you. Amen. Today, Cody and Taylor, you are surrounded by your family and friends, all of whom are gathered to witness your marriage and to share in the joy of this occasion, which we hope will be one of the most memorable and happy days of your life. You are well aware, though, that happy lives don't just happen. They are made. They flourish when husband and wife consciously...
Conscientiously?
There you go. See? Already working together. Decisions and relationships through all of life's circumstances. Work hard at making their home life mutually satisfying. A home where Christ rules over each heart, as well as over the family. In Colossians 3, I'm not even ad-libbing, I'm making it fun. In Colossians 3, the Apostle Paul writes, "Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, and humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity." Today, as you exchange marriage vows, I'm going to ask you to promise to do just that. I beg you to seriously consider the promises you are making to each other. I want to charge you, Cody and Taylor, to strive always to give your whole lives to one another, to clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, and humility, gentleness, and patience, to forgive one another impulsively and extravagantly. In expanding your energies towards the end, I can assure you, on authority of the Word of God, that you will find the joy and fulfillment in which most married couples only dream. Cody and Taylor have prepared statements they would like to make to each other. With these vows, they affirm their love for each other and make themselves accountable to you, their family, and friends.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
Cody?
Taylor, you are my best friend, my rock, my everything. You have been by my side through a lot the last few years, good and bad. We have come a long way from trying to balance a Dr. Pepper can. Everything we've been through has led to this moment. From this day on, I know nothing will stop us from growing together. My love for you will never cease or stop growing. I can't wait for the twists and turns life will give us, because it will be our adventure. Our future will be great, full of happiness and great memories. From this day on, I promise to be your rock, to be there for you. I will get you through the rough times and try to make the bad times good. I will try to make every day better for you. I promise to love and protect you the rest of our lives. Finally, I promise to try and be everything for you that you are to me.
Cody, you solemnly promise before Almighty God and in the presence of these witnesses to accept Taylor as your lawfully wedded wife, pledging yourself to perform those duties that encourage the building of a successful home, to love, honor, and cherish her until this union into which you all now entering is dissolved by death.
I do.
Should have went first. Cody, my best friend, my love, my Prince Charming. Who knew that a conversation about how to balance a Dr. Pepper can would lead to this? Great minds think alike. If you would have told me 7.5 years ago that we would be standing here today getting married, I would have thought you were crazy and would have called you a liar. Even though our relationship started unconventional, I wouldn't change it for the world. We have been through so much over these last 7.5 years. From annoying each other that first year for articles and pictures, to herding a cow in red on our first date, to standing here today. You became my best friend, my shoulder to cry on, my rationale when I'm being irrational, which according to you is often. I cannot promise you much, but I can promise you that I will only be right 99% of the time. And I will be here by your side through thick and thin, forever and always. I don't know what our future holds, but I know as long as we have each other, we can get through anything. I cannot wait to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you, Cody Clayton Ewing.
Taylor, you solemnly promise before Almighty God and in the presence of these witnesses to accept Cody as your lawfully wedded husband and pledging yourself to perform those duties that encourage the building of a healthy home, to love, honor, and obey him until this union into which you are now entering is dissolved by death.
I do.
At this time, Cody and Taylor will assemble the Unity Cross, a beautiful sculpture they will display in their home to remind them of the covenant they are making today. In Genesis chapter 1, we read that God created man in his own image. That means that he created man bold, strong, to be a leader, to be a protector of his wife and family. The outer form of the Unity Cross represents the strength, leadership, and protection of the man. The book of Ephesians reminds husbands to love their wives as Christ loved the church, totally and completely giving himself for her. Genesis chapter 2, verses 20 to 23, tells us that the woman has taken from man the bride's piece of the Unity Cross, represents the beauty and the many, many capabilities of the woman, designed with intricate, beautiful detail and placed inside the protection of the groom's cross, completing the sculpture and representing the two becoming one. To complete this sculpture, representing the couple's covenant, we are placing three pegs to hold it together. These pegs represent the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, showing God's place in this covenant and the security and completeness that only the Heavenly Father can give. At this time, the three pegs will be placed into the Unity Cross, completing the sculpture. The sculpture tells us that a three-stranded cord is not easily broken. Matthew 19, 5-6 says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate."
Ring.
I'll smack it.
What you doing?
Yeah, I need both of them. Yeah. Yeah.
The wedding ring is an unbroken circle which symbolizes unending and everlasting love. and is a visible symbol which represents your inner commitment to one another. May your life together be blessed with everlasting happiness. Repeat after me. As I place this ring upon your hand,
as I place this ring upon your hand,
may our separate lives become one.
May our separate lives become one.
As we commit our everlasting love to each other.
As we commit our everlasting love to each other.
As I place this ring upon your hand.
As I place this ring upon your hand.
May our separate lives become one.
May our separate lives become one.
As we commit our everlasting love to each other.
As we commit our everlasting love to each other.
Dear Lord, you have combined two separate people to become one. Every day will be a journey, an excitement, so if they can keep the strength to communicate with each other every day that they have. It's never an easy task. It is a journey. It is amazing. It is something you don't get to relive. Thank you very much for bringing these two together and help them for the rest of their life. Amen. With the blessings of all the family and friends who are present, under the authority vested in me by the pastor, Randy Morgan, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Pronounce.
Is that better?
I think so. I don't know. We'll have to ask. Apparently, we're being critiqued.
Was that better?
It was great.
Okay. Apparently, we didn't do it well last year.
Here's to you. The Ewing.
Woo! Do you love the rain? Does it make you dance when you jump with your friends at a party? What's your favorite song? Does it make you smile? Do you think of me? When you close your eyes, tell me, what are you dreaming? Everything I wanna know at all. I'd spend 10,000 hours and 10,000 more. Oh, if that's what it takes to learn that sweetheart of yours. And I might. Did you get your middle name from your grandma? When you think about you forever now, do you think of me? When you close your eyes, tell me, what are you dreaming? Everything I wanna know it all. I'd spend 10,000 hours and 10,000 more. Oh, if that's what it takes to learn that sweetheart of yours. And I might never.
You.
It ain't easy putting up with a road dog with a cup with a little Jack in it. You talk about the backseat. I don't know, don't ask me how she sat in it. She carried my burdens and paid my bail, put a Tennessee breeze in my Carolina sail and set me free. I don't pray much anymore, Lord, it's all true but overs. Happiness, wishes, wants and needs into my robes, hopes and dreams. Spend my living giving thanks for the ships I've never seen. Every big, every little, and the everyday things. The notes and the words and the songs I sing to the ones doing life with me. Could have easily said goodbye to this runaway train you're tied to. I know I don't get it, baby, how you roll with it. Fists and the fights and the scars of the battle, the ups and the downs of the judge's gavel. How'd you wind up in my unravel? I don't pray much anymore, but it's all true but ours. Happiness, wishes, wants and needs into my robes, hopes and dreams. Spend my living giving thanks for the ships I've never seen. Every big, every little, and the everyday things. The notes and the words and the songs I sing to the ones doing life with me. You're my faith and the grace every sunrise brings. Set me free. I don't pray much anymore. But it's all true but ours. Happiness, wishes, wants and needs into my robes, hopes and dreams. Spend my living giving thanks for the ships I've never seen. You're my faith in the grace every sunrise brings. Every big, every little, and the everyday things. The notes and the words and the songs I sing to the ones doing life with me. I was born in a town full of red pine trees. County sign says, follow your dreams. Westbound train makes the whole town shake. Friday night lights decide your fate. I'm born again in a church where the steeple's wide. Preacher preached, Book of John, and my mama cried. Meaning life was in verse 2. Didn't make sense till I found you. Pulled me.